Good morning, and welcome to your daily Farm and Home Show, brought to you by the University of Kentucky Cooperative Extension Service. And now, here's your host.
Good morning, and welcome to your Farm and Home Show. I'm Joanna Coles, and this morning we're visiting with Adam Huber. He's the Allen County Extension Agent for Agriculture and Natural Resources. Good morning.
Morning, how are you?
Well, I'm glad you're here, Adam, because Adam's a new agent. When did you start?
March 1st.
March 1st, yep. So brand new, but already hit the ground running with a lot of programs that I'm really excited about to talk about this week. But one of those calls that I know you're getting and about everybody in South Central Kentucky is getting is about prussic acid.
That's right. We've been getting several calls over the past few weeks. You know, fall is here, the temperatures are starting to get cooler, and we're starting to get some frost. And that can be very detrimental to our livestock.
Yeah.
And one thing that we need to be concerned with is the prussic acid. And what that is a cyanide acid that occurs in Johnson grass after a frost.
Yeah, and you know, we've already had a couple frost events, but we're really not out of the woods until we get that killing frost come through.
Right.
We just haven't had that yet.
That's true. Yeah, a killing frost consists of the temperature 28 degrees and below. Mm-hmm. And so once you get to killing frost, 2 days after that killing frost, you'll be fine to let your livestock graze in those Johnson grass pastures. But you need to make sure that Johnson grass is dead, brown, and is dried up completely.
Yeah. And you know, we had a unique situation this year. Like, it always seems to happen in Kentucky, but we had such warm, wet weather that the Johnson grass was so lush.
Right.
And still actively growing.
That's true.
And you know, we had hay, because I probably in my 20 years haven't had this many calls about Johnson grass hay. We've always talked about the grazing aspect of it.
Right.
But not necessarily the hay.
Right. Yeah, and it's the same goes for the hay as well. You know, once you lay that hay on the ground, you need to make sure that it gets dried and let it sit for, you know, 2, 3, 4 days. Make sure it gets brown and dead and dried up, and you'll be good to go to roll that up and save it for the winter.
Now, we've kind of had this roller coaster of temperatures, but it's kind of warmer, but we know we're going to get those frost events happen.
Right.
What's the safe way if you're grazing, you have Johnson grass in your pastures, how long should you wait after that light frost if you're in a grazing?
After a non-killing frost, which would be 29 degrees and above, you would need to wait 2 weeks after that frost before it would be safe to put those livestock in on that pasture. You know, 2 weeks, that gives the time for that acid to kind of detox.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, you'll be fine after that.
Yeah, and a lot of people might say, Adam, I don't have a pasture that doesn't have some Johnson grass in it.
Right.
So, you know, we just need to be aware of symptoms and what might happen.
Right, yeah. The symptoms of prussic acid poisoning would be rapid breathing and salivation and muscle spasm. So you can tell pretty quickly after the intake that Johnson grass and that prussic acid very quickly, you know, you can tell within 10 to 15 minutes, actually.
Yeah.
So pretty quick.
And a lot of times we're not out there. So unfortunately, sometimes the first sign is an animal that has passed away.
Yeah.
And that's a problem because that really hurts the bottom line. We've lost an animal. And for something that we know that it's there, we know that Johnson grass is there, we need to take efforts. You know, I know night grazing, it increases our chances, actually.
That's very true. Yeah, you need to take all measures you can to try to prevent, you know, this prussic acid poison of your livestock. And another thing too is with the high winds that we've had the past couple of days, you know, cherry trees.
Oh, yeah.
That's another thing you need to think about. If you've got cherry trees along the side of your pasture, make sure to check your fence, make sure they're not down, make sure there's no branches falling into your pasture, because cherry trees as well carry prussic acid and can do the same thing to your livestock.
Yeah, you know, we hear a lot of Johnson grass this time of year, but there are other type of grasses and other situations where we can get in trouble too. So knowing what you have in your pastures,
yes,
and in your fence rows is super important to keeping your livestock safe and healthy.
That's very true.
Now, where can people find more information? Do we have a publication that kind of explains
that brings a great point here. You can go on to the University of Kentucky Agriculture and the Ag College of Ag website, and you can type in this ID 220, and this publication here is cyanide poisoning in ruminants. So this publication will tell you all you need to know as far as what you need to do, clinical signs, prevention, diagnostics, and treatments, and just a lot of good information here that you can get off of the university website.
Yeah, because a little preparation can go a long way, and especially when we cannot predict the weather.
That's true.
We have no control over that. At least we can be the most prepared that we possibly can to make sure that all of our livestock are safe and healthy. So, Adam, certainly appreciate you visiting with us today. And if you have questions, make sure to contact your local Extension office. We'd be happy to help. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.
If you have questions about today's topic, please call the Warren County Extension Office at the number on your screen. Thanks for watching and have a great day.